Let's welcome the 30
Good morning, Mr. Richard, and students. Foremost, just to set the record straight, I went to Atty Law School because the Salle didn't have a law school. So, even in Atty, I was still a La Salle. So, first off, what does it mean to be a La Salle? I remember when I first went to these halls that Brother Arvin was then the president. He told us that now you are Christian achievers for God and country. So, we were told that in everything you do, you must put God first and your peers and your country next. So, you might ask me, at this young age, why am I here? Why am I involved in the campaign of a presidential? Well, it's simple. Actually, I am for Mayor Duterte and I am in the campaign because I am concerned. I am concerned of my peers and my future. Without due respect to my co-presenters, of course they are already of age and they have already established themselves. They are already in their careers, they already have a family, they already have their houses, their businesses. But what about me? I am just a starting young professional. In the next 6 years, it will determine whether I will still have a job in the Philippines, would I still have opportunities in the Philippines. I think the same would go for you. In the next 6 years, when you graduate, it will determine whether you will still have a job to apply for, can you still apply for a job that you want, or would you have to lower yourselves because there are no jobs left. Will there still be crime and corruption? Would I have efficient government service? The next 6 years will determine this, and it will determine your future. That is why I am involved in this campaign. So, why am I for Mayor Duterte? I am for Mayor Duterte because if you watched his last debate, he said that he is concerned about securing the present generation and the future generation. For me, he is the only candidate with political will. So, what is this platform? So let me discuss to you three of most of the points in this comprehensive platform. So those that involve us would be first, peace and order. So peace and order. Now, if you read the news, you would see that somewhere in the business district of Makati, a girl was just picked up, put in a van, dragged somewhere, raped and left. In another scenario, there was a person who was in the court. She was just dragged out, taken somewhere, and she was killed. Now, when I was in college, although Taft Avenue wasn't the safest place to be, I could thank him that even the beggars before, so Jenny, I don't know if you even know her, she's a gay beggar. They still had modest lives. And they will tell you that crime is evident, but you can still do something about it. But now, crime is just prevailing, it's just everywhere. You can't even walk, going towards Marietta without fearing that, hey, someone might just grab me and put me in a van and drag me somewhere. So that is why peace and order is important. Now, how does Mayor Duterte plan to solve peace and order? First, he said that in order to solve peace and order, let us revamp the police system and the military. As of the moment, the police earn so much. So for fighting for your lives and for going to the mountains of hell, they just get a certain amount. Remember the Psalm 44? When they died, no one was accountable and no one would be answerable to their families. Now Mayor Duterte said, if we want these guys to really fight for the Philippines, especially now that there's a looming war between China, Korea, and whatever these guys, we should be concerned because these people, they are the ones we first throw in the mouth of death. Now, if they die, what happens to their families? What happens to their children? What happens to their wives? Who supports them? Now, Mayor Duterte said, if we ensure that our police force is told that whatever happens to you, we will take care of your family, then they will fight with all their hands. Second, efficiency in the government. Why am I concerned with efficiency in the government? Right now, we don't have MRTs that are working properly. When I was in college, we would ride the MRT from here to Arlena to watch a basketball game, and we would be back in line for our next class. And our professor are no license plates. I have to call in line for 3 hours just to be told, I'm sorry, we have no plastic parts for your license. We'll just tell you. So, is our government efficient? Yes, we have a government working. But is it efficient? Is it doing the job it's supposed to do? It's not. Next, change to federalism. Now, this is the ultimate change that Mayor Rico wants to present. It is, right now, we are in a unitary type of government where there is a president and everything is within a center. Now, what is federalism? Federalism will disperse the power and will give every region its own. So what is happening now? All of the exports, for example, of Mindanao, they give 70% of their GDP and what the 30% is distributed to the other regions. Now this is so small. In a region, in a federal type of government, each region keeps 70% of their gross income and they remit 30% to the national government for upkeep. Now why is this important? When I was in the South, I had a lot of classmates who were from the provinces. They were from Paola, they were from Alvarez, they were from Atty, they were from school. And they had to go to Manila just to study. They had to stay in the work. Why? Because there was no economic progress in each of their jobs. Now, do they really want to stay in Manila? If you ask them, they would love to stay in Paola, Cebu, Davao, Tabato. The problem was, there was no job opportunity for them there. So in federalism, the amount of the economic growth would be dispersed. So each region would have economic progress. So let's see. Why am I here? Because again, the last 6 years will be crucial for my future and your future. And the next 6 years will determine if Metro Manila is deliverable or if it's good. Just it. The next 6 years will determine whether the Filipinos live in fear of criminals or the criminals in fear of law. Now, the next 6 years will determine if you will still have employment opportunities in the Philippines. The next 6 years will determine if our Muslim brothers already have a voice. Now, what is in a leader? I think a leader should actually know how to be. That put in the circumstances, he would know what to do in a heartbeat. You can't wait for someone to tell you something when the person you're supposed to save is already dying in front of you. You have to decide, and this is crucial. Now, a leader should know the history, the culture, the people of the Philippines, because he is actually a Filipino and he actually lived in the Philippines. Who knows our Muslim brothers more than anyone of the candidates? Maybe Duterte does. Now, a leader should be, lastly, a leader should not be after the puffers of the government. We should not always be thinking behind our minds that someone might be stealing from us. They should actually be there to serve for the Philippines. So that is why I am should also think about the next 6 years because this will determine your future.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.